Good morning everyone. Today we are going to study biology. The last classes we studied about transportation and digestion. There are two main life processes. Then today we are going to study about excretion. We already know that our body produces some waste materials. The excretion means the process of removing the nitrogenous waste from our body. Nitrogenous waste. So, excretion is the biological process of removing nitrogenous waste from our body. The main nitrogenous waste from our body is urea. Urea is the main nitrogenous waste in our body. If this urea is a toxic substance, toxic one, it is harmful to our body. So, our body wants to remove this toxic substance urea. So that for removing that urea, this what system is helpful for the removing of urea nitrogenous waste from our body? And it's called, the process is called excretion. The system is called the excretory system. So next we are going to study about the structure of our excretory system. Excretory structure. The structure of our excretory system includes pair of kidneys, pair of ureters, one urinary bladder and urethra. The structure of our excretory system includes pair of kidneys, pair of ureters, one urinary bladder and one urethra. These are the structure of our excretory system. Then we are going to discuss about the function of each and every organs. The kidney and kidneys, urine formation. Urine formation is takes place in the kidneys. These two are renal vein. So, this renal arteries collect the blood from the impure blood from our body, that is urea based blood from the body, other body parts, and give to the kidney. In kidneys, urine formation takes place. The urine from the kidney, the urine is collected through the ureter and to urinary bladder. From the kidneys, the urine is collected. Urinary bladder collects urine from the kidney through this ureter. Then urinary bladder stores the urine and release through the urethra. Then here the renal arteries are there. Renal arteries collect the blood from the urea rich blood from the body parts and give to kidneys. In kidneys, urine formation takes place. The urine, the urinary bladder collect the urine from the kidney through ureter. The function of ureter is collect the urine from kidney to urinary bladder. The urinary bladder store urine through urethra. The urine is removed. These are the structure of excretory system. So our main excretory organ is the kidney. Is our main excretory organ. The blood vessels are related to kidney. Excretory system, kidney and water. Blood vessels are related to kidneys are called the renal. There are renal artery and the renal veins are there. The renal artery collect the urea blood. The urea is blood from the body parts and give to kidney. Urine formation takes place. The urinary bladder collect the blood from the kidney through ureter. Ureter collect the blood from the kidney to and give to urinary bladder. Urinary bladder collect the store the kidney urine and release through ureter. These are the structure of an excretory system. Then we are going to discuss about urine formation. Nephrons are the structure and the functional unit of a kidney. In each kidney, there are millions of nephrons are present in each kidney. So, nephrons are the structure and the functional unit of a kidney. In each kidney, there are millions of nephrons are present. Then we are going to do the structure of nephron. Structure of a nephron. These portions are called the proximal conduit or PCT. This is loop of Henle. This is DCT. And this is called the collecting duct. And this portion is called the glomerulus. This is the structure of a one nephron. Nephrons are the structure and the functional unit of the kidney. This is the structure of a one nephron. Then we are going through the process of urine formation. The urine formation mainly takes place in the three steps. Ultrafiltration. Reabsorption and tubular secretion. Information takes place in three steps: ultrafiltration, reabsorption, and tubular secretion. Then, this afferent arterioles collect the blood in pure blood and give to the Bowman's capsule. In this Bowman's capsule, these Bowman's capsules are acting like a filter. They filter the blood and the impurities go through the and the tubes. Then pure blood is go through the efferent arteriole. Take the efferent arteriole and go into the other parts of the body. So ultrafiltration is over. Ultrafiltration is blood is filtered. Blood filtered. Then second one is reabsorption. After the filtration, some useful substances. In the selective reabsorption, the useful substances like amino acids, glucose, sodium, etc. is filtered. In the selective, after the ultrafiltration. concentration, some useful substance is filtered. If this useful substance is reabsorbed, the tubules are reabsorb the useful substances. That step is called a reabsorption. After ultrafiltration, some selective reabsorption, there's some useful substances like amino acid, glucose, sodium, etc. is reabsorbed from the tubules. From the tubules, some useful substances is reabsorbed. That is called a reabsorption. Then, third one is tubular secretion. After the reabsorption process, then this PCT, leukocyte, and DCT, these three tubules are produced, secrete some ions like H plus or Na sodium plus, etc. Some ions, the tubules are secreted some ions for maintaining the electrolytic ionic balance of body. After reabsorption, the tubules PCT, DCT, and leukocyte secrete some ions like hydrogen ions, sodium ions, etc. for maintaining the electrolytic ionic balance. So, the reabsorption process is over. After reabsorption, the waste products are accumulated into the collection duct and released to the urine lab. These are the steps of a urine formation. In the urine formation, mainly three steps are involved. Alpha stretch, alpha filtration. This afferent action will part of the blood from the body and into the Bowman's capsule. This Bowman's capsule is act as a filter, and they filter the blood. The blood is filtered in the Bowman's capsule. Then after the filtration, some useful substance also filtered. Then the tubules are, these tubules are reabsorbed the useful substance like amino acid, glucose, etc. After the reabsorption, the tubules are secreted, the PCT, DCT, and leukocyte secrete some ions like hydrogen ions and sodium ions for maintaining our electrolytic ionic balance. After these three steps, the waste ingredients are going through the collection duct and released through the urethra. These are the steps of a urine formation.